To make one of these third hand wire holders, you need a couple clips, a heavy piece of wire, some of my scrap wire here, and something to wrap it around. I'm going to use a 3/4 drive extension. And let me get wrapping and I'll show you what we're going to do here with the wrapping. So here's where we are. Let me show you. I've got this twisted around here and like this. So I went around twice on this side, made a loop out like that, and then twice more on this side because I want both of my clips, both of these clips, on the same side. I don't want one on this side and then one over here. I want the wire straight across. Plus the fact this little tab will give me something to clamp to, and it'll give me something, you know, I can set something heavy on that. So that's what it looks like off of the form. And then I'll go attach these two clips on here. I've bared off enough wire that it will go inside there and I can solder it, connect it in there. To crimp this end on here, first I smashed over one side, then I'm going to go back and I'm going to smash over the other side on there so I have a good firm mechanical connection. Also, I put it up through this wire port, and when I solder that in there, that will be forever. So what I had to do to solder this was hold my soldering gun on this side and apply the solder through here. The outside of this thing is plated with something. It doesn't want to accept the solder, but the inside seems to. So, that side's soldered, then this side is prepared, and I'll go solder that, and we'll be done. And there we have it. It's all done. You can stretch it, bend it, whatever you need to adjust the wire length. This one will stand by itself, as you can see. Doesn't need that. Or you can set something heavy on it, like that, if you need to add a little bit more robustness to it. But there you have it, your own third hand. One tip when you're using these third hands to solder wires together like this is you want to make sure that these tips are spread out far enough that they're outside the hot zone, because when this joint heats up and the heat starts to spread, these clips have enough pressure and they're sharp enough that they can squeeze through the insulation. Then you'll end up with insulation's a weak spot or bad spot. One tip you can do to avoid that, first of all, you can spread these out as far as you can go to make sure it doesn't happen, but you can use like a wet piece of tissue and wrap them in that zone, just drape them over there on each side, and you'll help cut the heat down and avoid that insulation puncture.